If that one thing is not there, this is an uphill task. This one thing must happen to you, isn't it? This one thing every human being deserves, isn't it, Swami? That's the most significant thing. That is the most important thing in your life.
Namaskaram everyone. Now I know that we all are quite excited to see Sadhguru, right? Well, this video is for that update only, that in no time we are going to see Sadhguru talking with us once again. But before revealing the actual date, that when Sadhguru is going to be in front of us, there is one more important thing that I just want to make assure of, or just want to share, whatever you can say. So do watch the video till the end and don't try to scroll the video, because you will miss the most important thing. So now, since our Guru is going to come between us, are we all prepared for it? Some of you might be thinking that, okay, what preparation do we need to do? You all are right. I mean, what preparation we need to do, right? Sadhguru is not coming personally to our home. But friends, very soon we all are going to see him. What offering do you want to make? He has given his life to us. So what are we going to present him after so long? He is going to talk with us. Now before you think of something, I just want to show a small old video of his. So just see the full video.
Well, how to make my home, my work, everything as an ashram.
You should give it all away to me. Really? Anyway, I'm not going to come and eat in your house every day. But in your mind, you must give it away. Because here you're doing it as an offering, it's a beautiful thing. There you're doing it as a chore, it's an ugly thing. Both the same work, it's just you, isn't it? Same dishes, same work, just you. Who can make it either miserable or joyful? So even what you do at home and office, why don't you do it as an offering? What's stopping you? I won't ask for you, I won't come and steal your salary, I won't come and eat your food. Why don't you just do it as an offering? It'll work beautifully. It'll work beautifully, not only because your mindset has changed, above all you become receptive for grace. That's the most significant thing. That is the most important thing in your life, to become available to grace. If that one thing is not there, this is an uphill task. Uphill task. Quite an impossible task. I wouldn't say impossible, but torturous. If you go with grace, you glide effortlessly, joyfully. If you try to walk, then it is a very torturous journey. We do not know what big things will become in your life, whether you are going to become a billionaire or not, we do not know. But this one thing you deserve, that the process of life was a pleasant experience for you. This one thing must happen to you, isn't it? This one thing every human being deserves, isn't it so? Other things according to their capabilities. This one thing every human being deserves, that you make the experience of life into a pleasant process. If this one thing happens, life is beautiful. According to our capabilities, each one will do whatever we can do. So this is all the choice you have. You can either do your life willingly or unwillingly. If you do it willingly, it becomes your heaven. If you do it unwillingly, it'll become your hell. Learning to become willing in all kinds of situations, that you do every moment of your life willingly, not unwillingly. Because the moment unwillingness comes, even if the most beautiful thing is happening to you, it feels like you're being buggered by life. You're unwilling, but we'll push you into heaven, you'll suffer. How do you know you're not already in heaven? Is there any proof? Is there any proof in your hands that this is not heaven? Then, because you're unwilling, even the heaven is ugly. If you're willing, it's very beautiful. And only if you are willing, you become available to grace. Otherwise, you have to plod every step. which is not easy.
Now, after watching this small video, I just want to reveal that Sadhguru is going to be present between us on 23rd September 2024, that is approximately 1 month from now. And why 23rd? What is so special about that day? Well, we all might be aware of that it is Sadhguru's Enlightenment Day. And Sadhguru is going to have a live darshan with all of us. We all can see Sadhguru. And this live session is going to be held on III, that is Isha Institute of Inner Sciences, Tennessee, USA. Yes, he is in USA, but we all will see him on 23rd. Now it's just approximately 1 month left. Are you ready to offer yourself or everything yours to him? Just take a pause and just think about it. Now, it is actually very simple, but because of our personality, it has become extremely complicated. The spiritual path by itself is not very complicated. The complexities that one encounters on the spiritual path aren't because of the path. It is just because of the mess that we have made in our mind. So, we all need the master's grace, right? To quell the madness of the mind. If we allow this, then the path of the spirituality is so simple. The path is the destination. The best thing to offer Sadhguru is ourselves. But before offering ourselves to him, are we in that state or not? Just start with this 30 days sadhana or challenge. And the sadhana is, so every action that you do from now, just see whether you are doing that action for the Guru or against your Guru. If you do this simple sadhana, all your things will be settled. And most importantly, your mind will be settled and we will be able to become more receptive on 23rd. Whatever you do, whether you do your daily sadhana, whether it is Shakti Chalana Kriya, Shambhavi, Shunya, or do your office work, homework, just a minute before, just remind yourself of your Guru. So just start doing this and just take a month challenge. Take a notebook like this. Write all the days, up to 30 days, like I have written on the top of each of the pages. Write all the sadhanas that you need to do and you will be doing, despite of your choice of likes and dislikes. Just keep separate all your likes and all your dislikes and just write in every page what you need to do for your daily sadhana and just work on it every day. Now, why sadhana am I telling is, and why in nearly all of my videos I always talk about sadhana is, because the sadhana is such a powerful tool, or we can say such a powerful weapon, even more stronger than a gun that we have got. And this sadhana is brought into our life so that the dimension of our life begins to move. Because of our compulsions, because of our karma, we are always left behind. Even in our sadhana, sometimes we start feeling laziness or feeling the mood of not doing it. To avoid all these, just take a month challenge, okay? And one thing you must remember, that if you are less with yourself, that is the best way to become receptive. And we all know that on 23rd of September, we need the receptiveness much more stronger to experience Sadhguru. And all the sadhanas that we do is always structured to absorb you into activity in such a way that in the daily process of living, we will forget who we are actually. We forget what our life is all about. And once we forget ourselves and our life, we become more compassionate and more passionate. And you are just absorbed into what is happening. So, are you all ready for it? And are you all excited to meet Sadhguru on 23rd September? So just do the practices, do as I have told, take a notebook, write all the dates, write all the sadhanas. And you all know why am I talking about sadhana. And so hope you all are excited about it, love the video and found it meaningful. And just comment me down in the comment section that what all sadhanas you do, what all practices you perform, or what all practices you are going to perform if you are not doing it regularly. Are you taking this 30 days challenge or not? Just comment me down in the comment section. And for now, hope you loved the video and really found it meaningful. Do share this with as many people as you want. And up to next, stay safe, healthy, happy, and namaskar.